Hey guys, so today is Mother's Day, so be nice to your moms. The other day, something really cool happened, which was that I have been wanting to do the acro class with Abby on Fridays just because, like, it's not like it's that I also have access to it with the worldwide. And stuff, and I remember I did it a few weeks ago, and really enjoyed it. I loved it, but I was a nervous wreck that day. That was no, because literally, here's the thing: I wasn't expecting. I didn't realize it was the acro class at first, and all of a sudden, I had logged on for some reason. I forget what it was. Like something about like a Friday. Oh, it was because I heard that Gianna Martello's their Friday. So I logged on, and then all of a sudden, Abby's assistant logged on and said, says, Abby will be on here in like 5 or 10 minutes. And I'm like freaking out. I started freaking out real bad because it was the first time I was seeing Abby since I became an Abby favorite, and I really didn't want her to say I'm not an Abby favorite anymore. Like, that was like going through my head. I was a wreck. And then I like went through, like, I told myself, okay, you're gonna drink some water real quick, stay hydrated. And then you're gonna take a deep breath, and you're just gonna go through this class, and you are gonna show that you aren't nervous and seem like you're happy and you're perfectly fine, like ready to go. And then all of a sudden, and like, so we like went through the class, and near the end, I had put something in the chat at the beginning, like it helps that I'm an Abby favorite, because it really does. Because it helps you a lot. Like, it helps you, not in the sense that she's not gonna be as hard on you, because she definitely is. In fact, she's probably gonna be harder on you. But it helps in the sense that that's like your ticket almost. It's like your way of like knowing Abby thinks I can make it in dance. That I have a great future in dance. This helps out a lot. Yeah. And so that like really helped. And so then all of a sudden I brought like Ab wanted me kind of talk at the end, and so I went like, yeah, I guess I'm a little nervous because being an Abby favorite is like a dream come true, and I don't want that taken away from me. And she's like, well, if I forget her exact words, but it was something like, well, if you keep working hard or something, and if you keep working hard, that being an Abby favorite will never go away. Like, you'll always be an Abby favorite. And you continue to work hard and follow your dream. Like, it was some, like, speech about, like, it was a really good speech. And since then, I've never been nervous to, like, see Abby ever again. I get really excited because, yeah. Then, and, like, after that, I was planning to do it, like, continue doing it. But then all of a sudden, I kept missing it for some. The first week, that was my fault. I didn't check the scheduling and stuff. Second week, I did, but like, I basically kept missing. And Friday. Yeah, Friday morning. I woke up and Dad said that he got an email saying that they were inviting us to everyone from the spring worldwide, which is what I'm doing because it's springtime, you know, like, to come join them on this acro class with Abby. And so, and it, like, gave us the time and everything, and that was really good. Good, and so I got to take the class. There were two things about it. The class was an hour long, which is tiring, but also, especially when the entire time you're just working on back bend and you're working on kicking up into a handstand. But, like, I was kind of nervous about the class because it went. My mom's first time meeting Abby, and my mom has never really liked Abby because she only sees TV Abby, and there's a difference between TV Abby and regular Abby. TV Abby is what you see on Dance Mom, like, I do whatever, like, the producers are telling her, and, like, you know, like, I'm screaming at parents and, like, that sort of stuff. That's TV Abby. Regular, everyday Abby is slightly different. She's still hard. You know, when you see her scream at kids on TV, she's hard. She does that. That's what she's known for. But regular, everyday Abby doesn't scream it at you. It's more like, okay, the 500th time you made the mistake after she told you 500 times, or as I like to put it, 3, then she can scream it at you. But that's not on her end. That's on your end for continuously making the mistake that she told you to fix. So, yeah. So I was nervous. And then the only two things was that at the end of it, I feel like I afterwards, what happened was that, when it was over, there were two things that I have to tell you that, like, which was that before it started, I told my parents, I went, like, you have 3 rules, like, you have your normal, I set rules for my parents. When doing it out there, you know, I do have rules. These rules are not hard to follow. They're very easy rules, and they're understandable, which is the first rule, which is you don't talk to me during class. Because you're interrupting me, you're taking me out of my zone, and that's rude to the teacher. You know, like, it's disrespectful to the teacher to have a parent interrupting class, even though we're on mute, but, like, still. That's rule number one. Rule number two is you don't correct me during class. This one is a very good rule. This one is one of my rules. The reason is because I feel like the only time that I ever let my parents correct me during class is when we have this one guy, either Taylor or Tyler, because whenever I'm in class with him, then they are allowed to correct me, but only because they're going to look at my mistake. My parents are sitting right there. Their only focus out of the class is on me, making sure, like, seeing what I'm doing and that sort of stuff. And so, like, that, but also because of the fact that he's a really good teacher. I'll admit, he's giving us steps. It always starts off like, I feel like it's steps that are kind of on the beginner side, but also, like, there are ways to make them advance if you want to and stuff. So he knows what he's teaching. And the steps are good. But that's not my issue. And he seems like a teacher that knows what he's doing. That's very important. And my only concern is that he doesn't look at anyone on Zoom. He gets mad when the people in person look at people on Zoom. And like this week, I think he held back a little this week, to be honest. Usually, only if they look at anyone on Zoom, he would tell them, like, you need to focus on yourself, not the people on the screen. And he did say that, but he only did it twice. And that's kind of like, oh, maybe he saw that my parents were in the background or something. Like, but he's a good teacher. And there are things that, like, he could work on as a teacher, but also he's a really great teacher, you know. Oh, and you have to give him that credit, at least. But, yeah, I only have, like, those. Oh, and I have, like, one more rule, which is that when it looks like I'm about to scream at myself, leave it. Don't try to fix it. I do have one more rule, actually, which... And the reason behind that rule is because I'm the type that I am hard on myself. I don't do good when you tell me I'm great and, like, I'm the greatest. Like, when you try to just say I'm great and, like, you don't really fix my mistakes and admit that I have mistakes, that's when I don't work well with you. I like being hard on myself. And sometimes to the point where, even though I'll never quit dance for them I plan right now, I always tell myself, if I'm, like, making a ton of mistakes, I tell myself, if you don't fix this mistake right now, you're quitting dance. And you're not coming back to it because you were too dumb to fix a mistake. Now, I would not advise that. That is how I look at it. I'm hard on myself. That's how I learn. I learn when I'm hard on myself and when it comes to dance. So, yeah. But my other rule is don't get mad when a teacher corrects me or, like, screams at me. You know? Now, I did that, but I added one rule for Afro, which is don't try your best not to get annoyed with Abby. Abby's just doing her job. And Mom's like, okay, fine. Like, at first she was kind of, like, not a fan of that rule. And then afterwards, I think she was more okay with that rule. But my parents did end up breaking one rule, which was, well, actually two. Well, no, it was one, but they broke it twice, which was, don't correct me, let the teacher do. And they broke the rule, like, three times so far, and I only done, like, two classes out there, which was, that we were getting ready with, like, we were getting ready, and, like, for class, I was logged on, and I was just kind of stretching, doing tilts, you know, like, fun little things, and before it was time to take the class, and, what happened was that my, mom, all of a sudden, I did a tilt, and my mouth was open wide. This was when we first went and switched over to Gianna Martello. That's right. Like, we had just, like, started with Gianna Martello, and I did a tilt. And then, all of a sudden, my mom, like, I know your mouth was open wide on that. Why was it? And I'm like, I, Mom, and you know the rules. And then she's like, yeah. And I'm like, if I made a mistake, Gianna would tell me. She would fix it. So, yeah, that was a fun little thing. And they broke that rule then. They broke it on Friday because I was working on, like, here's my thing. I can't kick up into a handstand. That takes a lot of work, a lot of hard practicing, and also, like, it takes a lot of, like, you can't kick up lightly. You actually gotta put some strength in, and just that I'm not good with that. So, and like that situation, and my parents kind of corrected me, and they went like, you need to kick up. And I'm like, I'm trying. And Abby did correct me a lot that day, and I was really upset with one. I'm not at her because she was doing fabulous, like doing her job correcting, but I was upset with myself because I know better than to make that mistake, which was, I naturally have technique. That's something that I feel like I'm very lucky to have. But, it's definitely challenging sometimes. Wrenching because I don't have, well, no, it's that I don't have flexibility. And so, but the technique I'm very, like, strong in. And for those who don't know what technique is, it's straight leg, pointed feet, in good posture, like things like that. And all of a sudden, I was working on kicking up into it, and then Abby said, well, always straighten that back leg. And I'm like, okay. Like, I gave her the thumbs up, you know. And then I was so mad at myself because that's technique, the thing that I have that I'm good at. So I was annoyed with myself. Tomorrow I have dance. I have ballet. And I don't think we're gonna get as lucky as last Monday because last Monday we got Angela. That was pretty lucky. You know, the weird thing is that I always like, I hope for Angela because I really like Angela. Angela, my type of teacher, because, like, she points out our mistakes, obviously, and then, but also, like, she's the type that, like, she loves hip-hop, like, she enjoys hip-hop and, like, that sort of stuff. And just, like, she's really incredible. But, the weird thing about it is that she makes it do conditioning every time. But she manages to make conditioning actually, like, somewhat fun. And, like, not the worst thing to ever exist. So, like, that's weird. Today is Mother's Day. I woke up really early. Because, actually, last night I worked on a few other Mother's Day gifts. I'm allowed to say because my mom already received her gifts. Like, but last night I was working on, like, two gifts plus something for me, which was that I really wanted like wall stickers, like dance related wall stickers, because we are planning to paint my room soon. It's not gonna be teal. My original plan was to make it terrorizing teal. This really nice teal color. I really do like the color, but I ended up going with like a fuchsia color because fuchsia is my favorite, and also I felt like I just like that a lot more. And for those who don't know what fuchsia is, it's kind of a mixture of like a pink and a purple. And I felt like it would match my like idea of my room very well, because I got like my palette bar kind of like it's primarily a pink, but with like a slight tint to it that makes it a little bit more towards like a purple almost. And like my room just has like those pinks and purple sort of thing to it a lot. Over there we have a painting. That painting I did like 2 years ago, and it just means a lot to me because I actually, no, it was like 3 or 4 because we were just moving in with my sister, and she pulled out a bunch of painting stuff for me and Bella's sister to like paint and have fun, and I painted this picture, and it's basically me and my crush on a beach, sitting on a bench, watching like the ocean that doesn't look much like an ocean, but like it kind of works, or even like the sun. Like it's a good, like I feel like it's one of my best paintings, because I'm not the type, I'm horrible at painting, and you give me something to like kind of paint, and that I don't have to like if you like give me like something to paint, I'm pretty good at it. But when you have me paint like a picture or something, and it's on like paper or canvas or something, and I'm not very good at it. I like when it's just already done for me, the design and stuff. I just get to paint it situation. But I painted that, and now that painting reminds me of what I hope one day will happen. I made the bench black, it's very cool. But last night, I was printing out, like, I wanted, like, dance-related, like, wall stickers. And I looked up a bunch of them, and I found a couple that I liked. But I kind of can't do that because I can't spend money, because like I owe my parents like over $300. Like I owe them a lot of money for these Zoom classes and stuff. And I will probably be paying them back for like the next 2 years, possibly longer. Yeah, it's gonna be a while before I can spend money. And so I wanted, like, I was thinking, and I'm like, that genius, I can just look up, like, dance images or, like, dance wallpapers and things like that. And then I can just print them out on sticker paper, because I had that for merch, but also occasionally it gets used. I have a lot of it, so, like, we're good. So what I did was, and it's waterproof, which I love. And this, I tested it. I did test it. And one of the things that I was worried about is it, like, willing to, like, stand? Like, is it waterproof to the point where, like, if we left it in water for a while, it would still be cool? Like, and so how I tested that, but I have like a little waterfall thing that I ordered from Five Below a couple of months ago. And like, It's like really good for like going to sleep and just it's really nice and stuff, and it gives me kind of like calm vibes, which is very good because my room very much does not have calm vibes. It very much has a lot of bright colors and things, and it's just not calm vibes at all. So it's nice to just have that one piece. So I stuck this sticker on there that was done with the sticker paper, and it kind of went with the waterfall thing. Like, we don't wait for like this. Let me actually read it. Life isn't about waiting for the storm to pass. We learn to dance in the rain or something like that. Is it? I was going to say I could check back here, but I wait. Life isn't about waiting for the storm to pass. It's about knowing to dance in the rain. Okay. But, yeah. So, I stuck it on there because it looks good. But my mom got a ton of gifts today. So, yeah, to the point where we now have a candy drawer. So, like, we were never, like, the candy drawer type. Like, we always just keep our candy, which I don't even like candy. I'm not a sweet eater. Like, in the, like, pantry. And, like, on the shelf, pretty much. But, today we had, like, an empty drawer in the living room that we put it all in. So, yeah, she got a ton of candy. I did make a video on that, like, putting in, like, a bag, kind of wrapping it, making a fun little, like, pop-out card. Like, you know, a fun little thing, which she enjoyed. But then on top of it, last night I made a few things. So last night I made this, like, keychain that, says Best Mom Ever on it, Sam. Because it's, like, kind of her gift from Sam, you know, like. And it's just a fun little keychain. And then what happened was, so I made that, and then I also threw in two other crafts, because we get a lot of craft kits, and there were two that I thought she would really like. One, you make like a fun little like wreath thing that seemed like something she would like to do, and I kind of, I'm not like super into it. I'm picky when it comes to my crafts. Like, there's certain in, like, craft, I'm like, no, if it has anything to do with sewing, and I'm just gonna end up gluing it. If it has anything to do with knitting or something like that, no, you can forget it. Like, that stuff. Like, I'm very, very, like, picky, kind of. So, the other thing was, like, this little, like, craft that involved, it basically makes kind of like, I'm trying to think, coasters. Like, you get to knit little, like, coaster things. That seemed like something my mom would like, because she loves sewing and, like, knitting and that sort of stuff. So, yeah. And then I made, so we have this one craft that I haven't gotten around to doing, so I did it last night for her, which makes a mermaid throw pillow, and that turned out really good, and she loves it. So, peace out.